We need to register this part. Perfect. So we send you a pre-registration link to all of you. So you need to complete this pre-registration form so that we know exactly the students who will apply between the 20th of April and the 20th of May. I will share my screen a second to all of you, and let me go to my email that I sent to all of you in the last couple of days. Not this one, I presume this one, yes. So I sent an email to all of you, and concerning, let me see here, one second, ladies and gentlemen, I'm just a little bit overwhelmed of email these days. So, okay. So this is the email that I sent to all of you. So as you can see, the application start on the 20th of April and end on the 20th of May. So it's very important that you will register your students during this time. You cannot register the students on the 18th of April, and you cannot register the students on the 21st of May, but only during this time. So in order that we know exactly who will register during this time, you need to complete a pre-application form. And I send you the link here. So you just have to click this link here. Now I will copy this a second, and I will open here on the right side. I apologize if I have so many things open on my computer, but it's very important these days. So you just have to put the name of your organization, your name, surname, and all the detail here, and the name of the students. So we know that you will register these students. When we receive this link, and we already received many of them, we already receive about, only today, I checked shortly, we receive about 12 applications, which is good. So every day we get application for the UNESCO Soprano. It's very important you complete this document before. When we receive this document, we are able to send you the application form for the University of Sopron. So let's go back to the email that I sent to you. So this is in regarding of the application. So the tuition fee is indicated on the information that I sent to you. So I sent to you several information. I can open now one, which is an introduction of the University of Sopron. Then there are many ways to say University of Sopron. My Hungarian is not so good, but I can see here the director of the University of Sopron is with us today. Mrs. Szabo. Hello, Mrs. Szabo. How are you today?
Fine, thank you. Greetings to everyone. Hello, Mr. Afota.
Hello, nice to have you here with us today. Thank you very much that you joined
us. Thank you for the invitation.
You're welcome. I know that you're very, very busy at the moment, and you have a delegation from Canada waiting for you. So thank you that you had time, 2-3 minutes, just to join us. Mrs. Zsolta Szabo is the director of the UNESCO Sopron, and WEBA and the UNESCO Sopron came into an agreement, and we are now promoting the UNESCO Sopron throughout our network of agents around the world. And I invited the director just to join us to see how we are running our usual webinar that we run in every week for our partner university. I was just say to the agents at the moment about university, how they have to start to do the application. And I received so many questions from agents in the last couple of days that is very, very interesting. Also, first of all, Hungary is in the heart of Europe. Hungary is part of the European Union. And this is a very important information for all of you to know. Hungary is part of the European Union, because I received this question as well. And let's go, first of all, a little bit to see where is Hungary. Hungary is in the heart of Europe, is close to Austria, is close to the Slovak Republic, is close to other countries who are, maybe Mr. Zoltan, if you want to say something, you're free to interrupt you all the time. But as you can see, Hungary is in the heart of Europe. And it's a good step. Students like to go to Hungary. Personally, I went many times to Hungary myself. I even spent my Christmas holiday to Hungary with my family. And I really like the country. It's a very nice place for students. They really enjoy it. It's a great atmosphere. There are many young students study in Hungary from Southeast Asia, from Africa. I just checked with the UNESCO student mobility. There are more than 2,000 students from India, Pakistan, Sri Lanka, Nepal, Bangladesh, Nigeria, Cameroon, China, Taiwan, who study in Hungary last year. And it looked like Hungary is booming, is a very interesting country at the moment for international students. So I invite all of you to look into the University of Sopron as a partner university. Just to give you a short information about Sopron, is a nice city, is not the biggest city of Europe, but it's a very nice city. It's not too far from the capital city, it's about 2 hours, and is close to the border from Austria, from Slovak Republic. So students who are study in Hungary, they are able to travel as well inside the European Union. So that means if they want to spend the weekend in Austria or to Italy or to any other European Union, they are free to move around. So this is a little bit the university to give you an idea. This is a university who welcome a very high number of national and international students. They're located in a very great area, in a green area. And we know how important it is to study in a very nice place, which is a lot of green. So they have around 3,000 students. It's not the biggest university of Europe. It's not the smallest one. Is a middle university which have about 3,000 students. They offer 3 bachelor, 5 master, 3 PhD. They have different faculty and they have as well a very nice botanical garden. As you can see, they have the different faculties. They have the Faculty of Economic, Faculty of Pedagogy, Faculty of Forestry, and Faculty of Wood Engineering and Creative Industry. So there are different faculties, and this can be very interesting as well for your students. But I already sent you all this information to all of you by email, so it's very easy for you to open the attachment that I sent to you. You will find all this information, and you are even able to give a presentation to your students like I'm doing this to you now. And I will not read everything, but just to give you an idea, we are here on the first program, which is the Bachelor in International Business Economic and the Bachelor in Tourism and Catering. The tuition fee per semester, as I indicated you by email, is $1,850 per semester, and the next intake is in September. So this is very important for you to understand that the tuition fee, it's very competitive for Europe, $1,850 per semester. So that's mean in 1 year, you have to calculate it 1,850 times 2. So this is a little bit of the tuition fee regarding the majority of the international students who want to study in Hungary. They choose these 2 options. And then logically, there are other programs as well. And here you will find a little bit about the entry requirement, what students need to achieve, etc. But a very important point, and which I think it's very good for all of you to know, is that every student who registers at the University of Sopron receive an interview. So after you register your student, and after that you pay the $150 registration fee, you will receive a message from the university and they will arrange an interview. So it's very, very important that you follow strictly the email that I send to you. So every student, when they register, when we will send you the application form on the 20th of April, you will need to register the students, and it's important that your students will pay this registration fee of $150 immediately, not waiting too long, because logically they have a time limit. Usually we always say within 2 weeks they have to pay the $150. So the University of Sopron is able to arrange an interview with your students. If the students will pass the interview, then we go into the next step. The next step, as I mentioned to you, is to pay the first semester, depend from the program the student choose. If they choose one, the program that I indicated before is $1,850. So there is no other way. This is the policy of the university, and it's not possible to make the payment after the visa, etc. So the student has to pay this has to make this payment of $1,850. When the university receives this, then the university will issue the letter for apply for the visa. So very important, follow exactly how I indicated in the email. There is no other way. If you know from the beginning that the students will not pay the 150 registration fee, do not book the students. It will make no sense for you and for the university. And if you know from the beginning the students will not pay the $1,850 in case they choose tourism and catering, do not book the students. Very important, you only book the students when you know that the student is able to make the payment for the registration first in order to get the interview. And then if the student has the possibility to make the payment of the first semester in order to receive the letter for apply for visa. We got many, many requests. In the last, in the last 7 days, I think we get around 150 requests of agents wanting to work with the University of Sopron. Logically, not everyone has the students who are ready to apply between the 20th of April and the 20th of May. But I invite you, all of you, if you have any students, make sure that they will register during this time and follow exactly what I indicated in my email. I repeat myself many times because I'm still getting message, it's possible to do this, it's possible to do that. No, we have to be very, very strict. This is the only way. Now, let's go back and forward to other program as well. As you can see, they offer as well master program. So the master program has another tuition fee and is indicated in the presentation. I get several requests of email and WhatsApp message and ask me how much is the cost of the master fee. So this documentation is attached in the email that I sent to you. And it's exactly here what I show to you here. And in this presentation is mentioned $2,750 for the different master they are offering. Then in regard of the entry, a master entry requirement, everything is written here as well. So you will find all the information, exactly what is the English level to enter. Logically, the university needs always as well a curriculum vitae and a motivation letter. This is fundamental. They use more or less the same system like when you register your students into the UK university. So it's not much different. So very important is a very good curriculum vitae and a very good motivation letter. Why they want to study at the University of Sopron? How they find out about the University of Sopron? Where the University of Sopron is located? Why they want to choose to do one of these programs? So they have to put a very important motivation letter so that the University of Sopron know exactly, this student is serious. They really want to apply in our university. I explain this all the time as well for all the university we're working together, but it's important that I repeat myself all the time. There is possibility to do as well a PhD and more, but now I think is the most period of the time is the bachelor and the master. The next intake is September, and then there will be another intake later on next year. But now we are working exactly for the period of September. So it's changed, the interview time is changed, is between the 20. This presentation was made early on in January, February, but everything is changed, is you have to book between the 5th, the 20 April and the 20 May, and the decision will be done by the 50 June, just to give you an idea. But maybe there will be a couple of days more, but this is the timing that we have to go with the final decision from the university. Many students received a visa to go to Hungary. I saw last year Hungary was one of the top country which give out visa, especially for students coming from Southeast Asia and from Africa. So first come, first serve. I always suggest everyone to try to book as soon as possible, because logically the capacity of the school is not the biggest one. So not that you book and then we have to say to you, I'm sorry, there is no capacity anymore for your students. So in affair of the accommodation, this is one of the questions that I get all the time. So accommodation is from 150 euro per month. So it can happen, maybe that will be more expensive. It can be 200, 120, 150, depends from the accommodation a student will choose. The dormitory is from 150 euro per month, just to give you a short orientation. And this is a good part. The university has a dormitory, which they are working together and is walking distance from the university, from the city center, and from all the shops around, just to give you a short orientation. Now, what I think it's very important for you to know is that there are other options. They don't have to stay at the dormitory. If they want to rent an apartment, they can rent an apartment. It's up to them. We just give the option of the dormitory, and then every student is free to choose. Now, I invited here Dr. Zoltan Szabo, the director of the Supron, because I wanted to ask him two, three questions, and then I let him go. Dr. Szabo, I have two, three questions I want to ask you. I always get the question, what is the entry requirement in terms of English level? And, you know, we know that they have to provide an IELTS 5.5 in all the four components, or TOEFL, or Cambridge. Do you accept as well Duolingo?
Well, I'm sorry to say, but Duolingo is not on the preferred list. So we prefer the TOEFL and IELTS, or even Cambridge language exams. These are the most known and the most reliable ones.
Okay.
But in case the student is coming from a country where the English is, let's say, official language, in this case, we don't require a language exam. Of course, the proper English knowledge is still required.
So this means, for example, Nigeria, if a student study for 5 years English, they should not, they don't need anything.
In case of this opportunity, the students has to show with the certificates that he or she has studied in a secondary school where they had all the subjects in English.
Perfect, perfect. This is a very important point, ladies and gentlemen. So I know some of the students study in India as well, the last 5 years in English. So if they can provide, if they can prove this, and then where during the interview or pre the interview, they need to provide all this documentation, then everything will go much, much easier. The same is with Bangladesh students. If they can prove this, then it should not be a problem. Thank you very much, Mr. Szabo, for answering me these questions. Maybe you want to add something about my short presentation, Mr. Szabo.
Well, basically, thank you very much for your presentation, because I guess I couldn't have done better. Mm-hmm. So you provided most of the crucial information, but I also would like to draw the attention that my colleague is going to take the opportunity to answer some questions. My colleague is Katalin Krajcár-Sharim. She is also in this meeting, and I'm going to leave in a couple of minutes to meet the delegation from Canada, but she is still available for another couple of minutes before she is also leaving for the official purposes. So she will stay here.
Fantastic. Hello, Katalin. Can you come on board? Let's see if Katalin is able to come. Hello, Katalin.
Yes, hello. I'm here.
How are you?
Hello, everyone. Great, thank you. And you?
Yeah, fine. Thank you. Yeah. Right. Yep. We are now in the middle of the webinar with some of our sub agents. By the way, this webinar is recorded, so we will be able to send this out to all the other agents who was not able to join us this morning. Katalin, I started to introduce a bit of the University of Sopron with the different questions, et cetera, et cetera. That I received since about 10 days. And it looked like many agents are seriously interested to send students to your university. I want to ask you, first of all, do you want to add something more about what I said before? You're more than welcome, Katalin.
Yes, your presentation was perfect. You really mentioned everything important about the application process. Just to reinforce the information that the application is online, is through our website, and we request if somebody is coming through an agent, the agent to do the application on behalf of the student. It is easy for us as well to recognize, to identify from where the application is coming from and who is responsible for the contact.
Yeah, for this, I send an email to everyone. They have to fill out a pre-application form so we know exactly from yes. which agent is coming from.
Great. So
this is a very important point. But yes. in terms of the entry requirement, I'm starting to get in questions on the chat system. Yes. I thought mm-hmm. you read this as well from some of the agents. For example, one agent from Pakistan is asking me if this option of the English is possible for Pakistan as well. Pakistan, by my experience, Kathleen, is that there are students who study in certain university and students study in other university. In the UK, we created a list of Pakistani university together with the Minister of Education from the UK. And we have this list available now in our office here at Weber. And I'm very happy to send this list to you, Kathleen. And students coming from this university and want to do a master, they usually speak very fluent English. And they usually have a very high level of English. And this is why the university in the UK, they're accepting the students to do the master directly. But this is something that I wanted to ask you, Kathleen, how did you handle the situation with Pakistan? Because with Nigeria is clear, with India is clear, but with Pakistan, how did you want to handle? You will decide this after the interview, how you handle this.
Well, as Zoltan mentioned, the official statement of the university is the requirement of language exams. However, if these students from these universities can prove that they have English subjects, they have the bachelor degree done in the university, and part of it was in English, actually, so not English classes, but some subject studied in English, and they can prove it with the certificate, and it's welcome.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much, Kathleen. So I think the reply was made to Mr. Mohammed Ali. And then we have some more questions. This is a question that came out all the time, the gap. The gap between, some of the bachelor gap usually is 2 years, 3 years, 4 years. Master can be 5 to 7 years. I always say to the agent, the important is to prepare a very good curriculum so that the university will know exactly what the student did during this time, etc. I don't know, Kathleen, how you can help me on these questions.
Sorry, what do you mean by gap? Is a gap year between the bachelor and the master? So how many years did the student work between
opposite.
Or?
Opposite, sometimes students decide to do a bachelor when they are already 23 years old or 24 years old. Is this still possible?
Yes.
Because the gap.
We don't have an age limit.
No age limit.
There's no age limit. Okay.
Of course, it is more convenient to work with, let's say, students at the age of 18, 20, and 19 if you are below 30.
Okay.
But we don't have an official age limit. We just advise that bachelor students should not be more than 30, but we don't have an age limit.
Okay. What about the master students? What about the master students?
No age limits. At the age of 70, you are still welcome.
Okay. Okay. So if
we have a statistics in Hungary that the oldest master registered was over 80.
Okay. Yes, it might have some issues with the visa. Mm-hmm. It can happen. So the authorities might ask, why at this age are you wanting to leave your country and study in another country? So it might give an issue to the student. However, there is no age limit.
So if a student is, for example, 35 years old and he wants to do a master, maybe he was a vice director from a bank in Karachi, in Pakistan, and he wants to do a master in Hungary, is possible?
It is.
Okay. Yes, he is welcome. At the university, we have no rejections against. He is or she is welcome.
Okay. You know, I just always try to put out these important questions. Then we have, okay, now, ladies and gentlemen, in effect of the registration fee of the $150 is not refundable. So it's not refundable. It's very important for you to understand why it's not refundable. I explain to you why. I mean, first of all, before to book the students, you have to make sure that the document that the students will provide to you are document that you have to read this document. You have to understand, okay, this student is eligible on your view. Logically, if you see the document and you see that, this student, 99% will never pass the interview, so do not register him. Maybe wait one more year. So this is something that I always suggest to all the agents. Read all the document that you receive. Prepare a very good letter of introduction of the student, an SOP, so a motivation letter, a good curriculum, so that when you have this in the hand, it's quite easy to say, okay, yes, you can manage, we will register you, you pay the $150. In case you will not pass the interview, what happened if someone will not pass the interview, Catherine? Can he repeat the interview maybe 2 weeks later? Because it can happen that the student is shy, the student doesn't have the good day. You know, it happened. They are young students. Sometimes I have 3 kids and I know how is it. Maybe one has not the best day of the day. You know, how you charge this? I mean, if someone is a bit nervous or maybe he has the bad day, let's put it like this one, Catherine, is there any option?
Well, as experience, we saw some cases where there were some difficulties, let's say, with joining, having online access or joining or hearing each other or issues with microphone and video. And there was no issue of organizing another appointment.
Okay.
So I would say it is not impossible. It also depends on the capacities. It also depends on how much applications do we have and how can we schedule the interviews within this period. You need to know that the admission committee consists of teachers who actually give classes and have limitations as well, and other official tasks, so have some time limits. But we try to fit everyone for a proper interview.
Yeah. What I always suggest to all the agents, and I suggest this in every webinar and in every workshop physically that I'm running, is to prepare the students for the interview. How you have to prepare the student? First of all, the students must be there on time. You know, if the meeting is at 9 o'clock Hungarian time, the students need to be there at least 10 minutes before, well-dressed, with a passport in the hand, with a good internet connection. He has to be sure that he's there with a good internet connection, not using any mobile phone, but using a computer. Make sure there is no noise around. Very important, no noise. You know how many students fail because of that? Because they're not well prepared. So your work is to prepare the students. Make sure to prepare the students. And then is the university who decide the timing? Is the timing of the interview is 8 o'clock? Is 8 o'clock? It's not that the student can say, oh, I cannot. I can have the meeting at 3 o'clock in the afternoon. No, it doesn't work like this. The university is very, very strict. Like in the UK, they are very strict. Is the meeting is 8 o'clock? Is 8 o'clock. Students need to be there 10 minutes before, well-dressed, copy of passport, good internet, have a good computer, no noise around, very good voice. So he has to test the day before, because this is the only way to start the interview. Make sure that the students visit the website of the University of Sopron. Make sure that the student is aware about which program he wants to book. Make sure that the students know how much is the cost. Make sure that the students know how many semester has to do for this program. So make sure that the students know exactly what is Hungary. make sure that the student is aware about the accommodation. This is a very important fact for the interview. Prepare your students. We even create a video which we will share to all of you how to prepare the students. But trust me, 50% of the application went wrong last year because of students was not there on time. They was not there with a computer. They show up with a mobile. And everything like this is failed. So this is one of the reasons of the $150 they have to pass the interview, and is up to the students if they want to manage to go at the University of Sopron. Then the next step is when they pass the interview, they will receive a confirmation, and then the students need to pay the first semester. Okay, the student needs to pay the first semester within 10 working days, not within 2 months, within 10 working days, 10, 12. We can be a little bit flexible, but they have to be ready to pay this amount of fee in order that the university can register the students. If they don't receive the money, they cannot register the students, and as well there, it's over. So very important, logically, if for any reason the students will not get the visa, the university will refund 90% of the tuition fee. They will keep the 10% for them for their own administration fee. Is this correct, Mr. Zabo? Okay, perfect.
Yes, it is.
If I say something wrong, I prefer to ask you about...
No, then I would immediately raise my hand, but I haven't, so... Thank you.
Thank you very much. Sorry, ladies and gentlemen, that I'm very strict with all of this, but it's very important that the students is well prepared. Now, another important question is, what about the financial document? The financial document or bank balance the students has to prepare. Kathleen, based on your experience, what kind of financial document the students need to prepare?
For the interview or for the application, we do not need financial document, but for the visa interview, they need to be prepared, and they need to show the financial background that they have the credit for, or they have the amount of money available to pay at least the first year.
Perfect. So that means if a student will do, for example, a bachelor and one semester is 1,850, they have to show that they have at least 1,850 times two, which is $3,700. But
at least, but and living costs as well.
Living costs.
So we say around $6,000. Let's put it like this one.
Yes.
This is the fee that I suggest to everyone. And a very important, ladies and gentlemen, the embassy, they call the bank. We know this by experience. The embassy are calling the bank. So it's important that this fee is inside in the bank account from the parents at least 6 months before. Not that maybe 1 week before someone will put the money inside in the bank and friends and cousins, etc., and then they show a balance. No, doesn't work like this. The money should be in the bank account at least 6 months, because when the embassy is calling the bank to double check if this is true or not, if they find out that in the last 2-3 weeks people put money inside in the bank account, they will never give you a visa. This is just to give you a short information about the financial point. Someone asked me, but the embassy need a statement from 6 months. But usually, more you can prove, better it is. They don't ask for a statement of 6 months. They don't. But what I say is, make sure that this family have enough. They have this $5,000-$6,000 in the bank account since about 6 months. This is what I suggest. This is a suggestion that I can give you just to avoid disappointment, because in the end of the day, you want that the students will get a visa to go to Hungary. So make sure this part. Okay, has to leave.
Sorry. I have to say goodbye.
Yep.
Mr. Zabo, it was great to meet you all. And I hope that we can answer, and Kathleen will answer all your questions with the help of Mr. Afflotter. Thank you very much. And I hope that we will have a mutually successful relationship. Thank you very much. Goodbye.
Thank you. Bye-bye. So we are remaining here with Katalin from the University of Sopron. So again, someone is asking me how much is the deposit they have to pay. They don't have to pay deposit. They have to pay $150 when they register the student. And then after the interview, if the interview is passed, they have to pay the first semester. So the first semester is based on the program they choose. If they choose a program which costs $1,850, they have to pay $1,850. This is already the first semester. So it's not a deposit, just to make this clear. And after this, the university will issue the letter for apply for visa. Katalin, you want to add something on this part?
Yes, if the dormitory is also required, they also need to pay the first month's dormitory fee, which is 150 euros. That also has to be paid in advance. And we suggest to do it before the visa process, because the certificate of accommodation is also an important document at the visa interview. And the dormitory can issue the certificate of accommodation when the first month's deposit is paid. So it's 150 euros plus, but it is then sure that the student, when he's arriving, has the accommodation.
Yep, this is quite common in Europe. University students need to pay the first month of accommodation in advance. So they can prove to the embassy, in this case to the Hungarian embassy, that they already pay 1 month in advance. So this will help them to receive a very positive reply to get the visa to come to Hungary at the University of Sopron. I have one more question that I want to ask you, Katalin, which I think is always very, very important, is the timing. How long it will take the time to, let's say, when they apply at the Hungarian embassy until they get the confirmation, usually?
I cannot say for sure. It depends on embassy, it depends on country, but it takes time, at least 1 month or two. Okay. That is also the reason why we have this strict application period with the strict end of 20th of May, because we need to calculate with the visa interview appointment usually takes a lot of time. And the students have to wait a lot for the appointment. And then the decision-making is at least 30 days or up to 60 days, or there are some countries where it's up to 90 days.
Yeah.
And then the organization of the travel, buying the plane tickets, et cetera, takes time. And we have a gap of the first, let's say, 3 weeks for the students that they can arrive until the end of September.
Okay, this is
about. But yes, but then if they cannot arrive by the end of September, then they won't be able to start the semester, because then they will miss too much of the classes. In Hungary, by rule, you can miss 3 classes of one subject in a semester.
Okay.
So if they come after the end of September, they will just be missing too much.
So, ladies and gentlemen, what Katalin say, make early application. This is very, very important. Early application is fundamental. I sent to everyone an email today and yesterday, and the email is, ladies and gentlemen, I just need to show the email I sent out today. 1 second. So the email, which is in front of you, you will see there is an application form, a pre-application form. You have to fill out this one. This is very, very important. Fill out this pre-application form before the 20th of April, or because on the 20th of April, we will send you the application form. So fill out this one so we know the name of the student, et cetera, et cetera. So we can register this under your agency. So we make sure that you will receive your commission that is paid out. Very important, when you have a student, you have to fill out this form here that I sent to you by email. And it's important you book your student between the 20 April and the 20 May. This is a very important, I repeat this one more time, so everyone is clear on this. I have more questions that coming in. Again, we have the questions regarding the financial. Income source. What I mean about income source, ladies and gentlemen, is every family who has a student who want to send to Hungary need to provide something, how they get the money. Logically, maybe the father working in a company, or he's an owner, or maybe they have a house, they have some land. Every time, whatever embassy you go in the world, you have to show more evidence as possible. This is a good logical way for an embassy to decide if the student has enough financial possibility to cover his own expenses during his period when he is studying in Hungary. So this is the answer in refer of the income source. Then in refer of the gap, we come back with the gap. There is no gap in Hungary. There is no gap. So the students can be 25 years to do a bachelor. They can be 40 to do a master. There is absolutely no gap, ladies and gentlemen. So this is a very important part. I think we covered the majority of the point about discussion. If there are some more questions, ladies and gentlemen, just type down on the chat system and I will be more than happy to answer to you. What is very important is regarding the course. Maybe, Kathleen, can you just refresh everyone the course that you're offering, the bachelor that you're offering, and the master that you are offering? But this is written here on the attachment. I sent to you all the attachment to all of you. You will find all the program. If you click on Unisupron flyer, you will find exactly all the program that is offering by the Unisupron. So, but just to refresh a little bit, everyone, they have a four bachelor. Is this correct?
Three bachelor.
Yes. Okay. Sorry.
Yeah. No problem.
I don't have the glass on. This is. Then you have a master program as well. You have master in. Yes. In different field, and everyone is written here, so we don't have to repeat everything. You are all professional, so you have all these details. Maybe if you want to add some point here, Kathleen, you're more than welcome.
Yes, just 2 points I wanted to add. I saw a question about the work permit. With the student visa, it is possible to work 30 hours a week.
Okay.
How many? In Hungary. 30.
30.
Yes.
Wow, every week.
Yes. It's almost a full-time job. Okay. But I would say in the first year, I don't recommend it for the students to start to work besides their studies. In Hungary, it is usual to have a 4 hours job or 6 hours job. So it's 20 to 30 hours a week. And there are some possibilities around in the region. I suggest the students to spend the first year without working so that they have the financials well prepared for the first year. But from the second year, when they have already the local knowledge, they know the country, they know the region, they know the teachers, they already have this experience of time management of their studies, they can go and apply for a job. And after finishing their studies, they can apply for a visa again and for a work permit again, of course. It is possible. But when the student visa ends, it is the end of it. So basically, if they don't apply for the work permit or other visa again on time, they might be obliged to go home. Yes, and about the programs, I don't want to go into very much details about the programs, but I wanted to emphasize that economy is always a very, very popular topic all around the globe. I can see it, economics and business and management is always a very welcome topic. However, our university with its full faculties has a very, very good global overview of the 21st century's issues, such as climate change and sustainability. And we have really, really good professional programs in forestry, like nature conservation and environmental engineering programs in master level, which are very much focused on these topics. And these professions will be highlighted in the coming years, I think. Not only economists will be valued on the labor market, but professionals really knowing a lot about sustainability and climate change will have a high value on the labor market. And such as timber industry is also a very important topic. We have timber industry engineering on all three levels available, bachelor, master, and PhD level. And as wood is one of the most important and sustainable materials all around the globe, I can really emphasize that these professions have also very good market value, not only economics and marketing and tourism and catering, because it sounds really cool and sounds nice and sounds easy to do. But those who are interested in the 21st century's challenges and sustainability, I really, really recommend these programs. And also, as you can see, the pedagogy and educational science program is also something really interesting. It is not specialized only on Hungarian education, but it is a global knowledge about psychology and early childhood pedagogy and sustainability again, and how to raise children of the future.
Katalin, thank you very much. Because of that, what is the academic requirement for bachelor degree? For example, GPA or percentage? You have these details available?
No, it is required to have the high school diploma and the English knowledge. Perfect. And of course, on the interview, we can, by experience, or our teachers by experience, they can learn a lot about the students' communication and motivation during the interview.
Perfect. Then another question is, we have a question from Kashif Vahid. IELTS score 5.5 overall, but how much score of for each component?
It's overall.
It's overall, okay. What is IELTS score for master and bachelor program both?
It is the same.
Yeah, perfect. This is some more question. In referral of the agreement, ladies and gentlemen, we will send after this meeting today here everyone the agreement to have an agreement with Weba in order to register the students at the University of Sopron. So you will receive the agreement, you sign this, and you send this back to us. Very simple. Then what else we have here? I think we covered the most of the questions. How much yearly income should the student need to show? This is around $5,000-$6,000 for your information. Okay, and one more question was here, visa refusal. How long does you need, will refund the tuition fee? The tuition fee will be refunded 90% will be refunded. So let the administration work. Usually it's about 1 month or 1.5 months until you receive the feedback. Logical has to be a letter from the Hungarian embassy, which explain exactly why the student was refused. This is a very important part. Not if the student just decide, oh, okay, I don't want to go anymore. I want my money back. No, it doesn't work like this. This, in case of visa refusal, must be explained what is the reason, but we can always reapply, as you know, with an embassy. You have 30 days time to reapply when you get a visa refusal. Maybe you have to provide some more document. Logical, what is very important is, as Katalin mentioned before, one the important document is as well the accommodation. So the students need to pay 1 month upfront the dormitory, which is 150 euros. So you need to show this, that the students pay as well at the dormitory for 1 month advance. This is a very important point. So we will try to help you as much as possible to prepare the student that he will not get a visa refusal, because we work on this. So this is a very important part. again, as well, visa refusal. Why visa refusal? Was the student late? Was the student not well-dressed? Was the student not with a good passport? Maybe the passport was not... So there are many questions sometimes why the visa was refused from the embassy. So we need to prepare the student as much as possible in a very good way and explain him to be ready to give a very good interview to the embassy and make sure that he know all the details, why he want to study in Hungary, how did he find out about the University of Sopron, which program he want to do it, where he will stay, where is located Sopron. So there are many questions that logically the student needs to be prepared from you in order that he will pass the interview at the embassy. Katalin, I want to thank you very, very much to be on board here today. If you want to say something finally,
Yes, I just saw one other question from Nepal that they need the offer letter to make an initial payment. There is the offer letter. So the decision about the admission, if the admission was successful, we send the offer letter stating that the interview was successful and then this is the offer letter. And we inform in this letter the students to pay the first semester tuition fee and then we issue that document, the acceptance letter that has to be shown at the visa.
Then we have another, we have someone who had a negative experience with Hungary, which is good. I mean, people have a positive experience, there are people have a negative experience. This is part of the world. But I always say, don't use one negative experience for everything, it's wrong. So a negative experience has to be put down and understand why and what happened and in what time. For example, now the application starts on the 20th of April and finish on the 20th of May. I don't know how was experience from this agent who had a negative experience. Logically, if he started in June or July with a Hungarian university, when the embassy is getting thousands of requests of interview, then logically there is no interview available anymore. This is one of the reasons why we start very early today and tomorrow and after tomorrow and start on the 20th of April. So that you are well in advance. And as Katalin mentioned before, there are some countries who take 90 days, 90, to get the official interview at the embassy. And then this is one of the reasons why we finish on the 20 May. So it's 20 June, 20 July, 20 August. Then the student can start in September. So we made all the, not me, but the University of Sopron made all the calculation in advance in order to avoid this problem that maybe some of you had when there was working with other university. And, you know, experience, we take everything negative, we transfer this in a positive experience for the common year. So we know this, and for this reason, we are working on this. Then we have other questions coming again from Nepal. We have to go to Delhi as we don't have an embassy in Nepal. Yes, exactly. There are certain countries, in this case, Nepal, Hungary, they need to go to Delhi. But the same is happening as well for Italy. Students need to go from Nepal to Calcutta for the Italian embassy in India. This is the situation, and we have to live with this. This is the situation with Nepal students. They need to go to Delhi. That's it. It's not much we can do. Here, Swiss, if I need to go, for example, to Uzbekistan, I need to go to Germany in Berlin to apply for the visa to enter in Uzbekistan. This is the situation we are in this world. It's not much we can change this. The same is with Nepal. They need to go to Delhi to apply for Hungary. Switzerland, myself, I have to go to Germany in Berlin to apply for Uzbekistan. So as you can see, every country has some issue with some embassy or not, but we cannot change the world. We can only have great students who want to study at the University of Sopron in the next intake starting in September. Katalin, thank you very much again. Very much appreciated your help, support as usual. And we keep in touch by email. Have a lovely day.
Thank you very much, Mr. Alfalter. Thank you. And goodbye.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
So ladies and gentlemen, we had with us here today Dr. Szabo, which was the director of University of Sopron. Now we had Katalin, who is helping Dr. Szabo and all the team with international students. I sent to all of you an email today, and I send you all the information, and I will resend again one more time this email. I send you as well the application form to pre-register the students. So very, very important, this one. So I will send today a copy of the agreement so that you can fill out and send back. I would like to thank you very much, everyone, to join me today. As usual, it's always very nice to have you here with me online or physically in one of my events around the world. You take care, be strong, and let's keep in touch, and let's do business together, and good health. All the best to everyone. You take care.